also the different activities that people are doing in their
It's a familiar scene, children turning into caregivers.
I wasn't finding solutions that would help her age in place.
This granddaughter is also a neuropsychologist at UC Davis Health studying dementia. And when her grandmother, who lived alone in Southern California, started showing signs of Alzheimer's,
I'll help.
Dr. Elisa Weekly created her own solutions for navigating long-distance caregiving for her family.
The goal for this research is for individuals to maintain as much independence for as long as possible with the assistance from these different technologies that we've been developing. So here's another sensor here, and it can detect us walking.
This is a simulation suite at the UC Davis Health System, originally built for in-home care nursing students. Weekly, an engineering colleague, Dr. Shizhua Pan, rigged the rooms with vibration sensors.
Plug and play sensors that you just plug into your wall, and it will be able to capture and analyze your routine based on the vibration you generate.
Here's how it works. The sensors can pick up when your elderly relative is moving and when they're taking their medicine, or more importantly, if they're not.
We see Michelle is picking up a pill bottle and put it down, which causes a vibration, and our system detects the medication interaction being recognized.
The sensors record vibrations in real time a caregiver across the country can watch.
With this project, we are trying to mitigate the caregivers, their burden, their stress, for better caring their family.
The cameras and microphones are only for the research, so students can tell which vibrations go with which activity.
This is what medication taking looks like. This is what walking looks like. This is what talking sounds like.
Technology that will give seniors the independence they want to keep as they age.
It's truly designed for and with individuals with cognitive impairment, as well as their caregivers.
While reassuring family members their loved one is safe and healthy. In Sacramento, Michelle Bandour, KCRA 3 News.
The doctors hope that their technology will eventually be built into new homes and assisted living facilities for seniors and could be purchased for individual families.